Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to see love in the general for the sign of Sagittarius for week ahead. So watch this video if you're a Sagittarius, sun, moon, rising, Venus, or if you're dealing with one. Keep in mind these are general readings, so it may or may not resonate. If it do not resonate, do not try to deliberately fit in, check in any other placement. If you want to have a personal reading, link is in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, where I keep on talking about switch words, manifestation, law of attraction, tarot, remedies, and all of that, then the link is in the description. You can go give me a follow there. All right, now let's see messages for Sagittarius for week ahead. Sagittarius, I see a new beginning right off the bat with the Ace of Wands, and this is going to be very sudden as well. So suddenly somebody might pop up in your life. Suddenly something might just take off. Like, you have been trying for this thing to pick up for a very long time, but I see now basically this is going to happen like a, you know, breath of fresh air. Suddenly something is going to turn around, which is good. Aces are always very, very welcomed in tarot readings. Now let's see present energy for Sagittarius. What is the present energy for Sagittarius, please? Three of Swords. Ooh. Ooh, Sagittarius, what is up? I see somebody might have betrayed you, and maybe there was a third party situation between you and someone. Something has caused you a lot of heartache. This could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius that you were dealing with. And this does not look very new. Like, so this is not something which has happened like 1 or 2 days back. I feel this is something which happened quite some time before, and now something basically came to the surface which kind of scratched your wound, all right? And you are getting reminded of whatever happened between you and this person. So an old wound is giving you discomfort right now in the present situation, is what I feel. What else? The Emperor. Ooh. Some of you, it was a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or an Aries that you were dealing with. Somebody was just very high-headed. I see this person was full of ego, quite a narcissist. You know, Emperor on its own is a good card, but when it gets combined with a negative card, this shows that this person does not care about anybody else. They just want to do what feels right to them, and even if it means of hurting somebody, or even if they have to hurt somebody to get to where they want to get, they will do it. So somebody has exactly done this to you. Like, this person kind of has hurt you, put you through trauma to get something in their life, all right? Or they just cared about their own image and their own stability, and they did not give much thought about you, is what I feel. Three of Pentacles. There was a third party situation. This is right off the bat, third party situation. Maybe this person chose someone else over you because they were getting more stability from that person, or they were getting some sort of benefit from that person. So you know how some people, they just leave their partners because, you know, they get some sort of benefit from someone. You know, like, that kind of people also exist in this world, and your person was exactly this. So this connection that has come down because somebody was very egotistical, and secondly, I see they chose someone else over you, and they chose that person because they were getting some sort of benefit from them, is what I see. Ooh, that is too much to take, Sagittarius. What the fuck? What is the future energy for Sagittarius now? Justice. Yeah. You're looking for justice. You feel that this person has done you nasty, and you're just waiting for karma to fuck this person, right? Isn't it? You're just hoping, when is karma going to do its part? Like, this person has put you through so much. You just every day wonder, is there something called as karma that exists? Because this person has put me through so much. When is this person going to get back their karma? So that is what you are thinking. I see, just hoping that karma gives this person their shit back, and it balances the situation for you. Okay, you are just hoping for justice. You feel that you don't want anything else but justice. You feel you did so much for this person, and all that they gave you was a third party situation or hurt. Now you just feel to get justice in the situation. Seven of Swords. This person was very, very sneaky. You could just never really guess where you stood with this person. You know, even when you were dating, they were not very upfront with you when it comes to communication. I see this person always lied to you. They used to, you know, run away from confrontations. Like, this person would never confront anything to you. They would never tell you the truth. they would always run away from confrontations. I see you were the one who was doing so many things, going above and beyond, and now this person has ghosted you. Something got revealed to you, or something is going to get revealed to you. And you know, I keep on picking third party situation. I keep on picking third party situation. Or somebody was having addiction issues, egotistical person, somebody who just thinks that they are above everybody else, that kind of a person. This was a lot that you went through. Some of it was the Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have Libra very strongly here, Aries very strongly here, Scorpio very strongly here so far. Some of you, I see that you maybe went through a divorce. So it's like the situation was almost on the verge of divorce, and now the proceedings are going on. I see it is going to happen very soon. So something is going to happen very soon. Some of you also will be getting to know something about this person. Something is going to come to the front, and it is going to give you a shocker, but not as much, because you already anticipated that this person is a piece of shit. So, you know, when this thing get revealed, you'll be like, yeah, I knew. I always knew that you were a piece of shit. So thanks for the confirmation. You know, that's going to be your reaction. You're just fed up of this person. You're fed up of this person's lies and repetitive narcissistic behavior. You're like, what the even fuck? Like, can you just behave? So what is the energy of Sagittarius towards this person? Nine of Cups. You had emotions for this person nonetheless, no matter what they did to you. You really hoped that this was the connection, this was the be all end all. You had very high hopes. So you see, this is what you feel about this person. It's like you feel that this person is some sort of soulmate or some sort of whatever, but you're not happy. See, her face is not very happy in this card. So I see that you really had very high hopes from this connection, but the way it has turned out to be is giving you shockers. You know, you're very disappointed from this person in their action. You could not even believe how they have behaved, because this seemed so good in the beginning. And now you're just trying to hold yourself back. Like, you have a lot to say to this person, but every time you just try to hold yourself back. You just try to console yourself. You just try to limit yourself. And you're just trying to show to the world that, you know, you're very strong and you're moving on and all of that. But something is bothering you deep down. I feel that. With the Six of Swords, I see gradually you are trying to move on. Some of you might be changing places as well. Some of you might be going abroad. Or I just see that mentally you are transiting to a much calmer water. Some of you, I also feel that this is a very random message, but I am getting that you have those emotional breakouts in the middle of the night. Like, you just wake up and start crying out of nowhere. You know, that could be your energy with the Nine of Cups, with the Six of Swords. But the good thing is that you are healing and you're moving on. Though it is a slow process that you're moving on, slowly healing yourself, but you are getting there. So yeah, I see that within 6 weeks from now, you will be in a much, much better position than what you are going through right now emotionally. A lot is happening in your life these days, Sagittarius. A lot is happening, I feel. And you're just somehow holding yourself. Somehow you're showing so much of strength. Though you feel very betrayed inside, but you're still showing up as a very courageous person. And this person that you were dealing with, they were so indecisive. You were planning for marriage and kids and all of that with this person, but what they give you was depression. Like, this person said that they gave you the word, but they gave you depression. Is that, I see. With the Ten of Cups, some of you, maybe you told your family about them, or family was involved, or friends were involved. So that is why it is very difficult for you to completely move on from this person. Some of you, you have a family involved, as I said. So maybe you and this person have kids together, or you have joint family together. I don't know. Something about family is also very prominent here. That is why it is very difficult for you to cut ties completely. You are just very upset that how could something so beautiful, which almost felt like a wish fulfillment, is now breaking off. So it is very difficult for you. It's a very hard pill to swallow for you. So what is the action of Sagittarius towards this person next? Fool card. Some of you just want to have a new beginning in your life. You feel enough is enough and you just want to move on, or you want to look for new opportunities. Some of you, you're not even focusing on this person, but you're looking for new opportunities in life, like career or maybe a new place to live in or just start a new work or something, you are going to distract yourself with something else. You're looking for a distraction so that you do not pay attention to this for some time. So you're looking for a new beginning in life. Some of you feel that it has been a very long time that you have been into this stagnation and now you just want to move past. Seven of Cups. Yeah, this is confusing the fuck out of you. Like, this person and their sneaky actions have been confusing you for such a long time. Like I say, even when you were with this person, you could never really guess what they were up to, and even now you're not able to guess anything about this person. So this person has been very sneaky right off the bat and from the very beginning. So you were dating a sneaky ass, you know. This person never told you their intentions clearly. And now you feel enough of sneakiness and enough of indecisiveness, you gotta move forward. Like, you're very determined to move forward or start something new in your life. Will you be able to do that or not? We will see in the outcome, but that is what you feel. Like, every day, you feel that I'm going to move away from this. I'm gonna move away from this. Like, you know, you're just trying to tell yourself that. What is this person's energy towards Sagittarius now in the present? Queen of Cups. Ooh, this person knows that you have a lot of feelings for them. They also might be having feelings, but you're still, you know, Queen of Cups is somebody who hides a lot, you know. So this person's energy towards you, some of you, they are playing mind games. Like, they are trying to do their mind games with you so that they can get a reaction out of you. So this person knows that you are attached. They might also be having feelings, but they just want to play games with you to see what you will do, Sagittarius. This is quite a sneaky, manipulative person that you're trying to deal with. And with the Ace of Wands, again, I see this person would try to reach out to you, but in their own sneaky way. So even when they come back, they're not going to give you the clarity. Some of you, this is going to start. It is going to pick up, but it's going to end at the same pace because this person is still not making their mind. Still very confused. Still not giving you the clarity. And they know that you have feelings or you are attached. That's why they are having fun with the process. They're like, yeah, Sagittarius is anyway going to wait for me. So why do I take the pain? You know, so with the Queen of Cups and the Ace of Wands, yeah, this person is looking for a new beginning with you, but just be careful because this person is still not coming with clarity towards you. Some of you, you already have anticipated that this person is going to make a move towards you, and I see they will. So yeah, your intuition is correct that this person is coming with the communication. And remember this Ace of Wands that we saw in the beginning, it is here again, new beginning. Very suddenly, this person is going to reach out to you, but be careful because this person is going to disappear at the same pace. You are waiting for a message and a message is going to come in. Ten of Pentacles and the Ace of Swords. The clarity that you have been waiting for is coming in. Some of you, I don't know why, but I keep on seeing families involved or kids are involved. That is also one thing which keeps you intact. You know, even here with the Queen of Cups, we have a kid. In the Sun card, we have a kid. In the Ten of Pentacles, we have a kid. Something about kids, something about family is very prominent. Maybe their family knows about you, your family knows about them, there is family involved, or you just have a family. I don't know. Something about that, something about kids is very prominent. That just keeps you guys bumping into each other over and over again. So it's like, no matter, you guys don't speak for days together, but then they again come back, and then they go, and then they come back, then they go, then they come back, you know, something about that. So yeah, this person is going to pop up again, but just be careful because this person is still very indecisive. But what I see is that you are going to get the clarity that you have been looking for. So whichever clarity or whichever answers that you have been looking for, that's coming in. This person also kind of know that you are trying to move on. And maybe that is why they are just trying to show back in your life so that you don't move on. Like, they just want you to be keep hanging in there. So that could be one thing. Very toxic person, you know, mind games and manipulativeness and all of that. You have been waiting for a message and I see that's coming in. Strength card. You are holding on to your strength. Some of you, you need to hold on to your strength. I see that this has been very exhaustive for you, Sagittarius, but you gotta show some strength, honey. Okay, this person's next action towards Sagittarius. Give me one more card. Four of Cups. See, again, they're not going to make up their mind. Even though with the Ace of Wands and the Ace of Swords, they are going to show up in your life, but this person is still going to be very indecisive. Some of you, this person plays a lot of fault-finding games with you. So every time they come back into your life, they try to tell you things like, you did that, blame games, fault finding and all of that. So that is also one problem, you know. So what's going to be the outcome between Sagittarius and their person? I see in the coming week your person is still not getting right. You know, they are just still repeating the same mistake is what I see. The outcome, the Eight of Pentacles, you guys will try to work this together. But it's going to take some time. So maybe 8 months from now. But this situation is going to hang in. See, like a lot of delays seen here. If you feel that this person should make things all right with you in the moment, it's not going to happen. This person is going to take a lot of time to act correct is what I see. However, with the Eight of Pentacles, I see that you guys will be working on the situation together. But with the Death and the Hanged Man, it's going to take a lot of time. Okay, anything for my singles? Single Sagittarius, Five of Swords. You're very bitter about a situation, something from your past haunts you still. You feel that everybody is a fuckboy or a fuckgirl. Page of Cups. There is someone who's going to come towards you. Could be a possible water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Somebody is up with a proposal towards you, but you are not going to pay much attention because you feel that this person is a fuckboy, fuckgirl. You're not trust. Yeah. Some of you, this person who's coming towards you is a past person. So you're not able to trust them this time around. What is this person's intentions towards my Sagittarius? Three of Wands. This person wants to take it forward with you, and this time they have changed. For my singles, this person has changed. This time they are going to talk about stability, but you feel this person is still a fuckboy, fuckgirl. So yeah, you have a hard time giving somebody a chance. However, love is coming towards you. But you feel this person is never going to change, so why do I give them a chance? So that is your call. But I see this person is changed. Yeah, King of Wands. However, this person still shows, you know, okay, so what I see is that when this person comes back, they will appear like they are a fuckboy or fuckgirl, yet, like, this person is very sexual is what I feel. But deep down, this person is now looking for commitment with you. The Page of Pentacles is a commitment card. And Page of Cups is emotion. So yeah, this person is no longer a fuckboy, fuckgirl. They might be very sexual though. But however, I see they have good intentions for you at their heart. This is for my singles, alright? Now let's see collective message for Sagittarius. Give me a romance angel card for Sagittarius, please, for week ahead. Free yourself. Yeah. Some of you are just overburdening yourself with a lot of things. You're doing a lot of things. You're thinking a lot, overthinking, crying, having sleepless night, whatever. Free yourself. Maybe try to go out with friends, connect with family, do something that makes you happy. Take back control of your life. You just have given control of your life to this person in the situation. Don't do that to yourself. Trust. Yeah, some of you. Some of you, you need to have more trust in the divine timing, in universe, that things are going to fall back again. Right now, your life might be scattered, but things are going to make sense once again. So you need to trust more. You're not trusting your own self is what I see. Prosperity lies ahead of you. Wow, that's good. Some of you, you might be getting connected with a Taurus. I see your money is going to improve with prosperity card. You are good enough. Some of you, the problem is you feel that you are not good enough. You feel this person cheated you because you had a problem. That's not correct. That person was having a problem. They are a cheater. They are a narcissist. Not you. Right? Don't try to take this person's blame games on yourself. Because this person has been playing blame games with you. You have started believing them. Don't believe them. I'm telling you. You are the perfect sweetheart. All right? You are perfect. You are good enough. All right? You just need to free yourself from that toxic loop that you have been into for some time now. So yeah, that was the reading. Hope this has resonated. If it does, make sure you subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next video. Till then, you guys take care, stay safe, bye.